a great time to spend time with the two children, and it's a lovely time with them because they are at such a beautiful age to watch them grow up. It's just the only real weapon against this virus is your body. You know, your body is the weapon. Your body has to create the antibodies to fight it out. There's no medicine. And that's, everyone's clear about that. Here, like for example, when we got ill, it was under our own responsibility to shut ourselves down. And that's what we did. The intention of that post was to reduce panic. And right now I'm understanding, after I did the post, is that people are embarrassed to talk about it. People are embarrassed to say they've got it, which I think is really strange, because I mean, it's not something that you've done. Don't panic, guys. Don't panic. You know, don't panic. Panic is the worst thing. दिमाग का पैनिक बदन में आ जाता है वो फिर.
Welcome to the virtual version of Speakeasy, Purab. Thank you so much for doing this. I know you have right now is definitely not easy with, you know, managing everything and of course taking care of yourself as well. So I appreciate that you're taking your time to do this. Thank you. First of all.
Actually, Rudrani, a lot of people are saying thanks but you know, we are very well now. We are fully recovered, and as we were talking before you started rolling the camera, there's a lot of free time on hand because everyone's sitting at home. So one is very, I mean, I'm very happy to do this. If it actually benefits taking off some of the panic that people are feeling.
Yeah, of course. And on that note, like you already said, you know, you're feeling better. You put a post out exactly for the specific reason of telling people that, you know, there is a lot of panic. Your family and you showed COVID-19 symptoms, and then your GP confirmed it to you, saying that you all have it. Now, could you tell us the entire experience as to how it happened and how eventually, you know, how did you sort of recover, what you were doing, things for people out there to understand what you went through?
So firstly, एक तो वी स्टार्टेड हियरिंग कि यहाँ पे लंदन में बहुत लोगों को COVID-19 हो रहा है, एंड देन they started shutting things down. It was an initial paper. In the initial time, they said that they want to keep things open and they wanted to bank on herd immunity and hope that 60% of the population will get the virus and become immune to it, and that will then help the rest of the 40% people not get the virus. That theory was bashed, and it was the government recalculated, saw numbers, and they said, okay, let's not do that. Let's shut down the country. And so that was all the initial talk was going on, and we were just like wondering, what should one do? How should one stay safe? And then we started following the system of washing your hands and staying at home as much as we could, going out only for necessary things. The lockdown here is not as harsh as it is in India. It's a little more lenient over here. So we were going out to get our essentials and do our things that we needed to do till one Saturday, which was about, for tomorrow it will be three Saturdays ago, that my daughter got a cold and a cough. Then on the Monday, my wife got a cough, and she said to me that, I think we've got the virus because this is a funny cough I've got. It's not a usual cough. On the Tuesday, I got a cold and it felt like a normal cold. And on the Wednesday, my son got a fever. So I still doubted it in the beginning. I said, no, this is, I mean, we are just feeling it because everyone's talking about it. But I mean, we've all got colds and fevers, and it's all funny. It just seems like some funny flu has come. But everyone, when they're talking about COVID, they're talking about only the cough. And we, all of us don't have the cough, only you have it. So that was my response to my wife. Only when we started talking to the GP, which was Thursday and Friday, and we kind of got a confirmation from them that all the symptoms we had are mild to medium COVID symptoms. And then on the Saturday, we also got a confirmation that someone who was in physical contact through my daughter and her nursery friend and all of that, his mother got serious and got taken to the hospital, and she was tested positive. Because if you get serious, then you get taken to the hospital and you're tested. So once that physical contact connection was made, and it became clear in my head also, theek hai bhaiya, ho gaya hai, abhi aaram se baitho tum ghar pe. You know, so, but we had pretty much shut down already. As soon as my daughter's symptoms, after my daughter's symptoms, when my wife's symptoms started showing, we kind of closed down. And once we spoke to the GP, we said very clearly to her that, we said very clearly that now we are not going to step out to the house till we are fully better. Thank you. I just got a grape for recovery for my daughter. Please. Thanks, darling.
What have you observed? When you were in London out there, what have been your observations about people taking the social distancing seriously here, And of course, like you said, you know, you've been in touch with your family there back, you know, I'm sure you've been telling them as well. So tell me what you have observed during this phase.
What have I observed here or what am I observing?
What have you observed there and what you've been talking to family out there as well? And, you know, when you sort of exchange that conversation, you know, what have you observed?
Well, I think here it's not as strict as India, where there is a lot of sort of responsibility given to the people to take this upon themselves. They are requesting people, they're putting out messages daily, they're putting out messages even from frontline workers in the hospitals, explaining what they are going through and requesting people to isolate and do social distancing. And people are doing their best. It's a very hard ask, you know, to ask everyone to sit at home, as you may be noticing in India also. People are reacting, saying that ki hum ghar pe kaise baithenge itna time ke liye. But it is a small ask in terms of what can happen if things go out of control, and how governments are trying to grapple with this situation at the moment. So here, like for example, when we got ill, it was under our own responsibility to shut ourselves down, and that's what we did. I think each government has their own stands on things, and the stand that they are taking is dependent on public health, public mental health, and I think also to a large extent what ability the government has to what is the ability of the government to deal with the situation if it gets worse. So right now the situation is, I mean, what we've been reading in the news is that this Easter weekend is going to be the peak of the situation here in the UK. So hopefully we'll see it plateau now. There are lots of deaths that are happening, as if you're in touch with proper news services, you'll get the numbers. People are dying and people are getting infected here. So they're hoping that it sort of plateaus in this week and things start returning to normal. There's also talk of reopening nurseries after the Easter holiday, which is at the end of this month. So, I mean, right now, one has to just sort of, I feel, if you ask me, what I'm noticing is that still everybody is trying to understand what is the best way to deal with this, because this is a new thing. Nobody is an expert really in this matter. Some people have had it. I mean, I can give you my experience and tell you what happened to me. But again, I'm saying my symptoms are very mild to medium. You know, there are a lot of people and we know of who are being taken to hospital. So nobody is understanding how this virus is working and how the disease is, the COVID, the sickness that you're getting through the virus, how it's impacting each human body. So one can only think of the fact that one has to stay at home for sure for two reasons. Number one, to safeguard it from spreading further on and very quickly. And number two is to sort of retain your own energy right now, you know, safeguard that, because God forbid if you do get the virus, then you need a lot of strength to fight it out. That's one of the things we noticed with us getting it, that more than anything else, we needed rest. You know, we just needed rest. We needed sleep. Body gets fatigued from fighting it. It's a battleground in there. The only real weapon against this virus is your body. You know, your body is the weapon. Your body has to create the antibodies to fight it out. There's no medicine. And that's, everyone's clear about that. So how do you keep your body strong enough to make it a powerful weapon against this virus? That should be the only thought in your mind. Resting it, not overexerting it, eating nicely, eating well, eating minerals, fruits, vegetables, keeping your body strong. I would say even light exercise, because for me, whenever I've been unwell, I've done light exercise and boosts your immunity. You know, so light exercise, of course, in India, you can't go out for exercise because the lockdown is much harsher over there. But even ghar pe, you can do lots of little things in little space. It's a very difficult situation in India, you know, because I mean, especially I've grown up in Mumbai, you know, mujhe pata hai ki wahan pe kuch areas mein aisa situation hai ki 10 log ek ghar mein rehte hain aur chhota sa ghar hai. तो क्या सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग रख सकते हैं वो इम्पॉसिबल वाला सिचुएशन है यू नो इट्स वेरी हार्ड वन पर्सन गेट्स इन द हाउसहोल्ड द होल हाउसहोल्ड इज गोइंग टू गेट इट लाइक दिस यू नो
आई थिंक पीपल वुड लाइक यू गिव अ फ्यू थिंग्स अबाउट हाउ टू कीप योरसेल्फ यू नो अ लिटिल बेटर एंड प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर इट यू सेड यू नो हैव दीस मिनरल्स एंड आर देयर अदर थिंग्स दैट यू डिड ड्यूरिंग योर रिकवरी फेज दैट यू वुड लाइक टू शेयर विद पीपल सो दैट दे कैन बी अवेयर वर यू ड्रिंकिंग you know, warm fluids? Were you doing things like that as well?
I think over the last, there's one thing that's not being talked about a lot in the media, and this is all over the world, not only in India, is the importance of, I mean, there is a talk of importance of immunity. But I think one medical system that really works towards balancing your energies and making your immunity strong is Ayurveda. You know, so that's something that me, my wife, and my children have followed, tried our best to follow for the last 3 or 4 years, an Ayurvedic sort of diet where we keep working with imbalances within our energies. And even amongst all these kada things that I took while we were sick, and I take every time. It's not like someone told me ki aap ye le lo aap theek ho jaoge. We only doing what I do for every time I get a flu. You know, salt water, gargles, steams, usme eucalyptus oil dal do, ya to fir honey ginger garlic. Ye to sab apne dadi ne bataya tha. Told my father. My father's told me. You know, hum log wahi karte aaye hain aur wahi kar rahe hain. What I also was taking was an Ayurvedic tonic, because as I said, we've been following Ayurvedic medicines for, and I wouldn't say medicines, because Ayurvedic medicines is your food, you know, what you eat. So we've been following an Ayurvedic diet for a few years now, and we had one tonic that was a cough syrup that my doctor had given me, and we had kept it here with us in London. So we took some doses of that, which was helping relax the cough a little bit. So, I mean, those are treatments that, you know, you try to, whatever, whenever you have a flu, cough, cold, we take these things. But whether they work or not, they worked for us. Whether they work on a larger scale, I don't think there's enough research, because the virus is very new.
How did you also reassure your parents? I'm sure now they are feeling better that you're recovering. I'm sure they're in Bombay, like you were telling me, your father's, you know, cleaning and things like that. How are they doing? How did they deal with all of this?
My parents, we were talking to them every day. My in-laws, we were talking to them every day and telling them how we are going. We didn't get really very unwell, you know, besides the cough, which was very annoying. It was not like I've had and I've seen my children have also much worse fevers and much worse colds and coughs. So like I said, our symptoms were very, very mild. And me and my daughter were extremely mild. My wife and my son were, say, medium symptoms, because they were hit stronger. But we, especially my parents in India, we were sort of giving them information only when we were better. You know, there's no point telling people you're so unwell and then start worrying from such a distance, they can't do anything. So what I did was, after we got better on the end of the first week, I called a very dear friend of mine, and I because I knew that he's like my brother, my childhood friend. I called him and I told him that, you know, because I told him what happened to us, because his parents are diabetic and heart patient, mother's heart patient, father's diabetic. So I called him because I knew he would be worrying about it. And I said, listen, this is what has happened to us, you know. And so he told me, why don't you make a video and post it out? Because after speaking to you, I felt very relaxed and calm, because everything is so panicky over here. So then I typed out a message and I sent it to my family, only to my family. You know, everybody, I said, this is what happened to us. This is what we went through. And then I got a lot of response from my family and close friends saying that, dude, you've really made us feel better by putting out this message. You must do a post, because everybody's panicking. We are forwarding your message around. So they forwarded my message around, and through my friend circle, it reached, you know, some of the two news channels, because I have a lot of friends in the media. And also my only intention of that post was to reduce panic. And right now I'm understanding, after I did the post, is that people are embarrassed to talk about it. People are embarrassed to say they've got it, which I think is really strange, because, I mean, it's not something that you've done something wrong and you've got it. Kisi ko bhi ho sakta hai ye bimari. You know, it's like a common cold. Aapko sardi hota hai, to ye bhi ho sakta hai. Aapko khasi hoti hai, to wo ye bhi ho sakta hai. Fever hota hai, to ye bhi ho sakta hai. You know, it's as simple as that. And anyone can get it. So there's no differentiator over here. One thing I'll tell you, which is what me and my wife both felt on the 6th to the 8th day, there is a sense of breathlessness. Aur agar aap us waqt pe thoda panic hoga aapke dimag mein, to wo panic aapke shareer mein bhi jayega. To aap kisi tarah se us panic ko reduce karo. आपका माइंड पॉजिटिव रखो, आप बिलीव करो कि आपका शरीर ये इससे लड़ सकता है. और डेफिनेटली आपको केयरफुल रहना चाहिए, आपको ध्यान देना चाहिए कि आप बाहर नहीं घूम रहे, मज़ा नहीं ले रहे जब ये चीज़ स्प्रेड हो रहा है, ताकि ये इसका जो स्प्रेडिंग है कम हो जाए या बंद हो जाए. उसके अलावा आपको पॉजिटिव साइड भी देखना चाहिए.
थैंक यू पूरब. इट्स आई एम श्योर अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल विल सी दिस आल्सो विल कम टू नो एंड विल गेट मोर इन्फॉर्मेशन आउट ऑफ योर एक्सपीरियंस एंड आई एम रियली ग्लैड दैट योर फैमिली एंड यू आर डूइंग रियली वेल. ऑन दैट नोट, इफ यू नो लाइक यू आर टेलिंग मी दैट इन लंदन द सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग हैज different ways of that they are doing it. Of course, you all are going out for walks, that you are being allowed, maintaining social distancing even then. But so you were telling me that you, you know, in a message, you told me that you are obviously going out sometimes for a ride or so, wherever you could.
Yeah, we between the family, we go out twice a day. Once we go out in the morning where we go to the shop and groceries to pick up something.
Yeah.
And maybe we have a small little park next to our house. So, bacche ko wahan pe thoda ghumate. That also, they have in the park, they have drawn lines where you can stand. The local government has put figures to show how much distance you have to keep from people. So, you can measure the distance. It's quite sweet. And in fact, I'll post an Instagram post tomorrow when I go to the garden of that. So you can see that it's very cute. They've drawn two figures and you can stand and see the distance you need to keep from people. So that's one time we go out in the morning, and I tend to go out in the afternoon or sometimes in the later morning after we come back from the shop for one exercise, maybe a run or a cycle I do. You know, the one thing that children love is the best is to spend time with their parents.
Yeah.
Last year, I was traveling so much between London and Bombay. So, I'm really happy that this year, I've done only two flights, going once and coming back once. So, I've had a great time to spend time with the two children. And it's a lovely time with them because they are in such a beautiful age to watch them grow up. It's just...
Thank you so much for doing this. Like I said, wishing you all the best.
I mean, my only intention to do this is to show people that one has to... You know, one of the things that my wife said to me on the first day that we got it... And we started talking, oh my God, is it COVID? Is it COVID? She said, you know what? Our bodies are strong. We'll fight this off. And that sat in my head, you know. So I think we have to believe that first. And with that belief, then you have to just do it, you know. I mean, there has to be some kind of josh from inside that will fight it off. And it will fight off. And don't panic, guys. Don't panic, you know. Don't panic. Panic is the worst thing. Dimag ka panic badan mein aa jata hai wo phir.
Cool. And on that note, thank you once again, Purab. It was lovely chatting with you. You please
thank
take
you,
care.
Yeah.
And you... stay safe. Thank you once again.
See you soon. Bye bye. Bye.
Bye.
Watch E Town News Monday to Friday at 9:30 p.m. only on Zoom.